So we're given a sequence and we're asked to find the form of the nth term of that sequence. This is basically just like a pattern finding problem, and these pattern finding skills in these sequences will be helpful for us when we start working a little bit more with series. So okay, let's do it. I think the pattern in the numerator is pretty clear. The numerator just goes 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and so on. So the nth term is going to have just an n in the numerator. Now, what about the denominator? Well, I'm noticing that the denominator does not increase linearly. You can find a pattern in how quickly the denominator increases, but this particular pattern that I just wrote down isn't going to directly lead us to a really nice answer for our denominator. So at this point you're wondering, is this denominator somehow related to maybe an n factorial? Could it be related to an n squared or an n cubed term? So you can start investigating a little bit. If we write down 1 factorial, 2 factorial, 3 factorial, and so on, and compare these values with the denominators that we have in this problem, you will probably not notice a correlation. However, if you write down a bunch of terms in the sequence for n squared, you get 1, 4, 9, 16, 25, and so on. And if you look at our denominators, it looks like each denominator is taking one of these n squared values and simply adding 1 to it. So this list of numbers here is giving us our denominators, and it looks to me from the sequence like our denominator is going to have the form n squared plus 1. To make sure that we got it right, it's probably a good idea to check. If we plug n equals 1 into this sequence, we get 1 over 1 squared plus 1 is 2. If we plug in n equals 2, we get 2 over 2 squared plus 1 equals 5. If we plug in n equals 3, we will get 3 over 3 squared plus 1, which is 10, and so on. So it looks like our answer checks out, and we're finished with this problem. Okay, I hope that helped.